We are live now, sir. Please go ahead.
सुप्रभात। सोचा हम रीजनल डायरेक्टर एसोचैम वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट वर्चुअल मीट ऑन करियर 2.0 अ स्टेप टुवर्ड्स क्रिएटिंग 21st सेंचुरी आत्मनिर्भर भारत द 2.0 इन दिस टाइटल इंडिकेट्स The new age of technology and skills, which is must for a candidate to process nowadays to establish a career. The life goal of a person generally revolves around what we want to become. The occupation that we want to pursue becomes a part of personal identity. A very good afternoon to the teachers and students gathered here today. Career. Important career forms an important part of person's life. Since it's a very young age, we invest heavily in building our careers. A career is generally a journey that an individual makes through education and work and forms a major part of their life. In this sense, occupation is just a part of career. It is a larger idea of the growth and development of. A recent survey, one of the online counselor platform, has revealed that a staggering 93% of the students aged between 14 to 21 were aware of different career options. Though there are more than 250 different career types of jobs opportunities available in India, are parents doing something wrong? In January 2021, India saw an unemployment rate of 4%. Was a significant improvement from the previous month. A impact on economy as large as India's caused due to a total lockdown was immense. Unemployment went up to nearly 24% in April 2020. This is probably a result of a decrease in demand as well as the disruption of workforce by companies. Not only school, colleges, and institutes are the place to impart knowledge. But to polish the skills and pave the path for every individual to success in his careers with the inclusion of pandemic, the role of skills and career choices have become more important to discuss. So here we are. So we have a specialist joining from the different part of the country, Professor Sanna Basu. She's Professor for Communication at Ford School of Management. Ms. Singh. Director, Mr. Nandan Kadam, Mr. Sinha, co-founder, Gravitas AI Consulting, Ms. I feel elated in welcoming Mr. Anu Singh. He is CEO for Speaking Minds and International Business Consultant, CEO's Club Network. He is a motivated business leader with a passion for creating value, innovation, and delivery technologies that have a positive impact on people's lives. Well over 25 plus years of demonstrative performance driving business at national and international market. So today's panel discussion is being moderated by Mr. Seth. So I hand it over to you. To you.
Thanks, Bharat, and thanks, Asochem, for putting up a very brilliant platform. And one good thing which I'll start with is like a lot of segments and the various segments of industries or other things are reaching to a level of 3.0, 4.0. Now we have something which is called careers, which is agnostic in all the categories. And it is also now graduating to a level called careers 2.0. So it's something exciting. And I would just say a thanks once again to all the esteemed panelists for sparing out their valuable time. And we look forward for an interactive session that how we are talking about careers and what is that we can expect in the time to come, and what is that is expected? For that, we have all these great people here in the panelists, right from a level of the industry to a professor, ma'am, to the dynamic entrepreneurs, personalities who are building up kindergartens to K-12, and all the segments will be covered here. So that's something exciting. And I'm sure jo hum log ka ek engagement rahega, that will be across various categories, various age groups, and how people can even look up to from a perspective that, oh, whether I should only go from a job direction or should I look at it as a career perspective, or how communication plays the most important role. So just to understand all these various perspectives and the various aspects of our life, because career is all about life. I think it's an old verb, proverb, adjective. I'm sure the eminent panelist here can correct me, and I wish to stand corrected by the end of the session, that how we should look at the way the dynamism is coming, the way the industries are changing, and we all are working towards Atmanirbhar Bharat, and the new things which are coming up is like India First. A lot of things are coming up. So without taking much time, I would first like to address and welcome our eminent panelist, Professor Suparna Basu ma'am. That ma'am, we would love to hear from you. And like you have been in communication expert, so definitely some guidance, shed some intelligence for our audience here. Ma'am, you have to unmute yourself. We can't hear you.
Thank you so much for inviting me. It's a privilege to be here, and thank you, Mr. Seth, for handing over the baton to me. It's going to be a difficult beginning, I can see that. Well, when in doubt, I always go to the data. From the outset, we may make many assumptions, but it's a good idea to let the data speak, and we can see how we may interpret the data, in what ways we can interpret the data. I said that I would talk about how do we build an ecosystem. Career 2.0, Atmanirbhar Bharat. Now, the reason why I mentioned an ecosystem. An ecosystem is an arrangement. It's an interaction between business, government, society. Society means individual actors. It means customers, organizations, business, government. The smoother the interaction is, and I think research has proved that the system-wide equilibrium can be reached through a good flow of talent, right? Organizations find new ways of speaking to customers. Distributed innovation takes place because of harnessing of talent, and a stronger ecosystem emerges. So if we have a good systemic equilibrium, if we have good resources, good talent, good initiatives, it is easier to connect with bigger value chains. Basically, we have a lot of emerging brands, emerging talents, emerging organizations, which then can connect because of their competence, harnessing competence, with larger organizations. Because today, one thing is proved because of this digital migration, it is not the big ticket organizations which are the game changers. It is the small MSMEs and the emerging organizations which are going to act the hub of innovation and are going to connect with bigger chains and become game changers. Let's look at some data. As I said, yes, there's a pandemic. Yes, we have suffered economically. But what does the data say? And I was looking at the Coursera report of 2020, and which benchmarked 60 countries of the world. And the report takes into account 65 million users on the platform, and takes performance data of users of over 12 months, 65 million users across the world. How does India fare? In data science, we are 51st in the world, which is a bit lagging globally, but we are 12th in Asia Pacific. In the business domain, we have overtaken China. Interesting. We are 34th in the world, which is ahead of China. And we are an emerging nation in this, and we are 8th in the Asia Pacific. when we look at technology domain, we are 40th in the world, which is an emerging rank, and we are 10th in Asia Pacific. So I would say there are two very clear in front of me, the business domain and the technology domain. India is emerging. This is data. This is not perceptually what we may feel to be correct or incorrect. Now, the report also states that India's workforce is expected to increase 27% to reach 600 million by 2022. Question is, how much of that is skilled workforce? It is expected to reach 27%. It is going to become 600 million by 2022. We will have that many graduates and postgraduates joining, trying to join the industry. Question is, what is the skill mix? Now, I was looking at EY report to look at that, what is the workforce mix of India look like? Right? Again, I'm going to talk a lot of data before we start analyzing. For 2022, because 21 is over, EY says that 9% this workforce mix will be deployed in jobs that do not even exist now. This is clearly the innovation domain. We don't even know what's going to emerge, right? For instance, one example could be if we start producing active pharma ingredients, APIs, those jobs don't emerge here right now.
Yeah, because they don't everything exist is right now
imported.
Yeah.
So 90% of biotech people could start that, or even when we use Facebook or any other app, we go through an intermediary. We don't produce that because of cost and other things. So see, the number is very low. 9% will be deployed in jobs that do not exist today, as of now. 37% would be deployed in jobs that have radically changed skill sets. Now, what are radically changed skill sets? Which refers clearly to, we have an ecosystem today, which is a digital ecosystem. We cannot do without technology. Even traditional customers have to look at customers very differently now. They look at the customers through a digital lens. Digital lens is unavoidable. So 37% will be deployed in jobs that have radically changed skill sets. And here, I think it would be important to connect to kids who are growing up with technology, business professionals who are coming out technology trained in blockchain and machine learning and AI-based sort of platforms. 54%, interestingly, will fall under unchanged job category. So basically we have, and it kind of, I saw the tally. So business domain, we are 34th emerging, 8th in Asia Pacific, overtaking China, yes, because 37% of the jobs will have radically changed skill sets. Mm-hmm. Technology domain, yes. In data science, we are lagging. No wonder we have 9% of the jobs which do not even have, we don't even have now. So if we kind of take this into account, 54% of the jobs, do we have enough people with necessary skill sets even to tackle those 54% of the jobs? This is where Career 2.0, and do stop me if I'm boring you. So Career 2.0 to me speaks, and I look at it in two ways, Career 2.0. One is, radically change skill set. So I have been working with certain skills. So how are organizations looking at employees, giving them fresh skill sets? Because 54% are still unchanged job category, but they will not function in the same way that they did before, because the ecosystem is a digital ecosystem. The second aspect of 2.0 speaks to me like, and I have spoken in this panel earlier, and I won't go back to it, is particularly to do with diversity and inclusion. Often women take a break from work, right? But they are very competent professionals. So should we go beyond the paper? to harness the potential that was already there, and given we have a work from home and hybrid workplaces,
correct.
Is it a 2.0 in a different way? It's a different managerial model altogether. So very competent professionals, I'm talking about women because that cause resonates with me very well. Even I took a break of 2 years after coming back from the US to look after my kid. And I was wondering, should I work right now? And that's a very difficult question for women. So should organizations look at what kind of talent you can tap into? Should you look beyond the paper? Should you look at, and I'm happy to see, once again, I looked up some data that Mahindra Group, Tata, Godrej, Accenture are already doing this.
So ma'am, I think before we jump to these corporates and some nice numbers or indicative numbers that you have shared, let's hear the perspective, like few things which you gave very well in terms of the growth and the way we are changing. And when you said that career 2.0 should be looked beyond paper, should it be more agile, should it be more changing? So moving on to here, I would just come to Ms. Vibha. Ma'am, what do you feel about, like, as a journey? Because I feel to your, the taking a point from a previous eminent panelist, that we are talking something which can't be decided in one day. So how do you see this as one journey? Like, is the perspective of kids changing? Is the perspective of parents changing? Or they collectively have to take a call in a new formats? Yes, they were. So we would love to hear from you. What's your take
Thank
on
you,
this?
Sir. Thank you, Seth, sir. First of all, a warm welcome and my warm regards to all the panelists. And I'm really grateful to ASSOCHAM to give me this opportunity to share my views. And coming to my point, now today we are talking about Career 2.0. So basically what I think, we are talking about changes in education sector. We had experienced during COVID period and in last few years. Technology has a game-changing potential and digital world has a large scope. Now, what should be the journey mapping from kindergarten to new age career choices? So first of all, whatever changes we could see last 1 year during COVID period, I want to talk about it. First, we have to accept the reality. We are working from home. We are digitally more sound and we are trying to be more sound. And altogether, we are moving in an era of digitalization. So time will not come again. Students need to understand that. Students who are preparing for even kindergarten or who are in a nursery school or who are in a 10th grade or 12th grade or preparing for job. Altogether, time will not come again. So students need to understand it and accept the truth that this is the only way of teaching nowadays, and it will be the way of teaching for few years. So value the online education. Don't play a blame game. Like online classes are boring, online teachers are not very digitally sound, or so many blame games are going on. But if this time will go on, this time will pass, and students will not understand and not value this 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, or we really don't know how long it will go. So we have to understand the value of education. And what will be the way of education? That is online education. So I just want to share it.
Yes.
Yes. So what, sir? Do you want to say something?
No. Please carry on. Carry on.
Yes. So if you are ready for job, first make sure you are digitally skilled, and not because without it, not only you will be survive, and survival will be difficult. Rather, your growth will be hampered. So it is very important to be digitally sound. We have no option otherwise.
Perfect. Just jumping on here, like you really spoke a good takeaway for technology. Even Professor Ma'am also mentioned about the way. So when we're talking so much of technology, I would love to hear from Mr. Mukesh as a technology expert on this panel. Before I head to Madam Archana, where we talk about lifestyle and personality. So Mr. Mukesh, we would love to have your viewpoint that how you see technology, because we all are talking on technology. But one thing is that they all are coming from an education domain. See, they all are talking technology. We would love to hear your perspective that you being in technology, how you can bring a value addition to education as a system. How you see is the scope.
Okay. I think Professor Basu and Biva Madam has talked about a lot about how in education particularly things are happening. And particularly Professor Basu Ma'am, you have talked about the data, right? Something 30%, something radical is going to be changed. And in fact, it is happening already. If you see in last 1.5 years, so when the entire world is going through the pandemic, and still you are working from your home, still your education is continue, which you have not thought before 2 years back, right? School kids from nursery to the university level, they have been learning at least something and getting promoted to the next level. It's a different thing. A debate is there whether it is right and wrong. So that is a different game altogether. But technology is helping you, even you are in the remote places in of the earth, if you have right attitude, you have right technology, you can learn. Not only you can learn, you can earn also. You have rightly mentioned, Professor Basu, that it's no more the game of the big companies. In fact, any new innovator companies, you have hearing about new billionaires. They are like first generation business, they are coming up. So if you have your idea, you have the technology, you can scale up, because scale up is only possible through the technology. Otherwise, the traditionally, when we talk about scale up, you need to build up the infrastructure, which is really very costly. So it was not a young people or young kid game that you can scale up in the few years. But we have been seeing that it is already happening. In fact, as far as I'm right, last year itself, 18 unicorn company happened from India. Unicorn, you have reached to the billionaires, and all these are first generation, in fact, business. They have not acquired business traditionally from the forefather or their family business. So technology, rapidly technology changes are happening. And particularly 4-5 sector, I would say education is one of them because of pandemic, in fact. Second is healthcare, drastically healthcare, digital healthcare is happening. People are getting treated in their home. So that is there. E-commerce, it was only the game for the big cities. Now we have seen that is e-commerce business are happening in the remote area, even block level or even to certain village level also, it is happening. FinTech, whatever we cannot able to achieve through the demonetization. Now this technology and pandemic help us to almost 60-70%. Now we have e-transaction are happening. These are the big changes are happening. And that is going to radicalize in another few years. So whether you like or not like, things are happening. Only good things I would say about this pandemic that it has given us the opportunity to reboot and refresh yourself. And of course, you need to come back. Otherwise, if you not change the technology, you will be obsolete. So you have no option, basically.
yes, sir.
New generation millennial is okay, little bit struggling and getting used to it. Already the next generation, it is called Generation Z. They are adapting the technology right from the beginning, from the 6th, 7th class onwards. So I would say a technology front, I think India is going to data. What are the indications? Definitely we are going to come up very well because our learning capabilities and I think resilience as average as for Indian is concerned is much better compared to any part of the world.
Great.
So,
yeah.
So it is happening. And second is just I would like to add another one line. It is affordable also. So it's no more, it is very costly. And the way I think 4G to 5G, we are in the process of migration. This will really game changer going to be happen. So if you're mentally prepared, you have infrastructure and 5G is coming and that too affordable. If you have idea, you can, what we have been saying for years, Vasudev Kutumbakam, you can realize this with your idea, you can acquire the world, not only the traditional big companies. So that is
very rightly said, Mukeshji. We will come back to you and would love to hear more of this wisdom, because if I was to assimilate, we spoke about journey, we are talking about technology. But one thing I look forward to hear from you panelists is like a take for all, that how we can leverage this technology for the benefit of our own community. Like, how is it helping us? How, if we are not leveraging or optimally utilizing this technology, whether in the current field of education, which you are talking about, Career 2.0, because it's changing completely. And we will come back to you, Professor Ma'am. We'll come back to you, Vibha Ma'am. Just, I would love to hear from another eminent panelist, Madam Archana. Ma'am, how do you feel, like, does personality play a role, or is it all technology? Is it my communication is equally important, or how I can leverage technology? Because one thing which is coming very strong from all of us and all the panelists is technology. Great. We have all high regards for technology. But what next, or what in conjunction to technology? If you can throw some light there. Ma'am, we can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you. We are not.
Yes. Thank you so much, Mr. Seth, for moderating this very, very important talk. And thanks to ASSOCHAM for having me once again. So I totally echo the views expressed by Professor Basu Singh and, of course, Mr. Sinha. Technology is indeed very important. But as you pointed out, Mr. Seth, you know, communication is something which is very, very important, and effective communication that forms the tool that can help you achieve the experience that we want to leave with the person we are in communication with, we are in conversation with. Now, how do we, you know, achieve that? Because the point is, if I'm not heard, if I'm not seen the right way, then there is no point of using the technology. Technology is your driver, but how you use it effectively so that the people around you hear you, listen to you, you're able to create an impact is what is important. That means it's a marriage between your thoughts and technology that takes you across the table. Now, how do we do that? So I will very quickly give few pointers which is important for people today to understand and incorporate in the way they are with people. Now, the first and foremost thing is very, very important is integrated communication. Point number one, integrated communication. What does that mean? You know, it's very important, you know, the way our communication flows. Like, for example, you know, this particular platform, ASSOCHAM, like, you know, there was a talk scheduled. There were so many people involved. There was a moderator, there was an organizer, there were panelists. Everybody in the team is well aware of what time the program is starting, who's going to be moderating it, what is the topic. So there is a flow of communication. This is one thing which children, students today need to understand, because as they go and grow into good professionals, the communication has to flow from one channel to the other. Why? So that everybody in the system knows what is happening. They are aware of what has to be done. The what, the why, the where, the who, everything is clear. You know, we should understand the 5 W's and the H. It's very, very important. Point number two, I feel it's very important for children, for students, for people who will be pursuing their careers going forward and using the technology, to stay away from ambiguity. So point number two, stay away from ambiguity. You have to be very focused. You have to be very clear with what you speak. What I'm talking should be heard, should be understood by the person on the other side. If it is not happening, you are not heard. People don't know what you're saying. You are simply mincing words. You have to come to the level where people understand you. because we are depending on technology. Technology is our driver that has helped us not stop communication. It has helped us not stop businesses or work. But if we are not clear in our thoughts, we are not sure what we have to speak, people will not understand. And if people do not understand you, then obviously there is going to be no exchange of thoughts, which means no progress, no interaction, no work. It doesn't make any sense. Another very important point, Mr. Seth, I feel it's very important to know your audience. Who am I going to be talking to? Now, how does one develop this? You have to be very sure what is this talk. For example, this particular meeting that we are doing today, I need to understand who's going to be listening to this conversation that we are having with such esteemed panelists. You know, if I don't know who's my audience, if I'm talking about London, if I'm talking about Tokyo and people don't understand it, there is no point. It should hit the bull's eye. The people who are listening to this, it should make sense to them. They should understand, yes, we want to understand what is integrated communication. We need to understand what is focus. We need to understand how we can leverage technology. So these things are very, very important. Also, children that really miss out today is body language. Trust me, Mr. Sage, today people feel that they are on cameras. Body language is still an important part. Even if I'm talking to you through camera, it's important for children to understand how body language plays an important role. You need to look into the eye of your camera. You need to still move your hands to express what you're saying. You still need to use voice modulation. You still need to ensure that you're at least 3/4 of your portion is being seen by the person on the other side of the camera, because that builds interest, that builds trust. If I only see your headshot, people will not trust me. They can't see the rest of me. So that language is really very, very important today. Also, I would like to stress on how important it is for children to understand that communication is a two-way responsibility. I cannot make it a one-way process. It has to be a dialogue. Like yourself, you're doing a beautiful job here. You're involving all the panelists, and the way you're taking forward the entire conversation, it is so beautiful. So this is the key of communication. It has to be an active participation of everybody, and that depends on you, how you do it. Involve your people. You know, if I don't, it doesn't make sense. It's just like I come, speak, and go. So it doesn't really make sense. So another very important point that comes in the highlight is...
No, we will come back to you. I think one shot people should grasp this, and I'll come back to you. And taking it forward, I love to hear from Dr. Ganga Prasad ji also, like as Mukesh ji mentioned about e-commerce, and he mentioned a word called ruler. Why I holded you, Arshana ma'am, in the middle is, you very rightly pointed the communication. I want to bring a different perspective of communication to the rural community of India, where we all are an agricultural community. We are the biggest producers in the world. We are among the top 3, 4, 5 in the different commodities. So we will hear from Mr. Ganga Prasad, and then we'll come back to you and understand how the bridge of technology. And one good thing that you brought is the power of you, means power of you being yourself. Your respect, your presentation, your packaging. So I'm sure the audience would love to hear your viewpoints in connection to communication to the rural India also. That's very, very important, because that is what will move towards Atmanirbhar Bharat and Atmanirbhar India, or India first. So Mr. Ganga Prasad, over to you. Dr. Saab, we would love to hear from you that how you feel technology is bringing a change in the so-called agricultural economy, which is India is known as an agricultural economy, and our market is so big. So we would love to hear your words of wisdom on this.
No doubt, technology is very important in every field. But how technology works in the rural area, as we know that, and as we all read in from the school level, that 75% of the population of India lives in the village. So if we do not develop the villager, then technology cannot spread throughout the India, and it will be not beneficial to anyone in the village side. So how 75% population will be benefited from this technology? Directly they cannot use the technology, so conversation, so communication from the technology should be reach to there. How this they will be reach? As you know that the knowledge management, as your topic is webinar of topic is knowledge management. So
yes.
What is the knowledge management? If there is any knowledge management is available existing in the rural area? No. Why no? Because only this knowledge management is confined to the 25% of the population of the India.
Mm-hmm.
So how 75% will develop? How communication will be developed in them? As my, I want to cite one example that आप जानते हैं कि इंडिया में जो विलेज में जो है एक जो ब्रांडेड कंपनी है वो विलेज का सामान को यूज करके कैसे आगे डेवलप करते हैं और उनको क्या मिलता है, उनको कैसे हम कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी कहाँ पहुंचा पा रहे हैं? टेक्नोलॉजी तो उनके पास है नहीं. अब एक एग्जांपल लीजिए चिप्स का. चिप्स बनता है इससे पोटैटो जो है उससे बन रहा है. अब पोटैटो बताइए उनको मिलता है क्या 10 रुपए 11 रुपए प्रति किलो मिलता है
किलो.
जो हमारे विलेजर्स है उनको मिलता है. अब इसके आधार पर हम उसी पोटैटो को चिप्स के रूप में लेते हैं 200 पर केजी. 200 रुपए तो उससे भी ज्यादा मिलता है. 400 लेज सबका बना के मिलता है, थोड़ा उसमें पैकेजिंग कर दिया और भी चीज डाल दिया उसको मिलता है इस तरह. तो कैसे हम टेक्नोलॉजी को वहां पहुंचा रहे हैं? कैसे टेक्नोलॉजी इज वर्किंग इन द रूरल एरिया? सो वी हैव टू डू सम थिंग्स विच कैन ट्रेन द ऑल फार्मर्स एंड रूरल विलेजर्स to gain the different types of knowledge, communication, and they store the data, they share the knowledge, and then they can develop. So only seeds bana dene se, scientist ka tarah tarah ke hybrid seed de dene se, unka development nahi ho sakta hai. Abhi kya ho raha hai, seeds aap dete hain, bahut tarah tarah ke scientific point of view se bana hua unko milta hai, le jaate hain kharid kar ki hum ja rahe hain, isse hamara bahut उपज बढ़ेगा, हमारा कैपेसिटी बढ़ेगा. लेकिन क्या होता है, जस्ट उसका उल्टा होता है. होता है कि जो लेगा उनको तो बताया नहीं गया कि किस सिचुएशन में, किस इन्वायरमेंट में, किस सॉइल में कैसे डेवलप करेगा, कैसे जर्मिनेट करेगा, कैसे हाई से हाई यील्ड देगा, ये तो उनको मालूम नहीं है. ले जाकर उसका पैसा भी उनको दंड हो जाता है. इस तरह की उनको टेक्नोलॉजी से कोई फायदा नहीं होता. हमको कुछ ऐसा काम करना पड़ेगा कि जो कि उनके लिए हर विलेज स्तर पर ट्रेनिंग देना पड़ेगा, स्किल डेवलपमेंट कराना पड़ेगा, उनके लिए सारा तैयारी करना पड़ेगा, तब उनका विकास हो सकता है. अगर उनका विकास नहीं होगा तो हम लोग का कंट्री का पूरा विकास ओनली 25% का विकास होगा. और धीरे धीरे क्या होगा, वो घटते जाएगा. 25 में भी कंपटीशन चलेगा और उसमें जो सर्वाइव करेगा उसमें 10% to 15% सर्वाइव करेगा, वो कन्फाइंड कर जाएगा, बाकी वो भी पीछे हो जाएगा. तो इस तरह से हमको नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट, वी हैव टू डू नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट इन द विलेजर साइड्स, एंड वी हैव ट्रेन्ड द ऑल फार्मर्स, एंड वी हैव गिव द ऑल इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ऑल डाटा टू द फार्मर्स एंड ट्रेन देम, देन दे कैन ग्रो.
No, Dr. Saab, first I will really thank you for highlighting some real facts, which is very encouraging. Yes, they looks very horrendous also, they looks worrisome, but I am sure the way we have our eminent panelist here, hum Madam Archana se kuch tips lenge, where she mentioned the words like integrated communication, effective communication. We will listen to Mr. Mukesh in a while, where he is talking about the way technology is changing. And even Professor Ma'am mentioned about the numbers, and she mentioned a good thing. Certain segment, close to 8-9% is going to the jobs which are not existing. So क्या हम उस non-existing jobs की तरफ बात कर रहे हैं? जैसे विभा मैम ने बोला कि planning पहले ही करनी है. So I'll come to you, Mukesh ji, back to you for a minute. and then I'll move to the integrated communication piece, because I think that is very, very important. Technology and you is very, very important in today's time. So Mukeshji, how you feel for our audience, and where you would like to add value, that how technology can be leveraged in this segment? Definitely there are a lot of things that are changing. It will take its own pace and time, but kuch ek future roadmap aap dikhana ya batana chahenge hamare audience ko here?
Yeah, it's a depend upon sector to sector, but the sector where I am working, like AI is there. So AI is rapidly getting enrolled in every and each home, whether you are knowing or not, it is already happening there. And these are going to impact the entire world, like all the 7 billion people across the world. So yes, yes, you have the technology. Right now, technology was only restricted to few big countries or so-called the developed countries. Mm-hmm. But the kind of India and developing country is taking forward because of IT regulation, and the new generation people are accepting in day-to-day life. It is going to break the barrier between have and have not. And we have seen with this mobile technology, right? So mobile technology, like each, even like village level, students are able to learn something there during this pandemic 1.5 years, just because of this accessibility and affordability both. Similarly, e-commerce, it is now reaching to the village level also. It is just because of this technology is affordable too. So over a period of time, I think affordabilities are changing. And since the country like India, which ensuring that everything to be access to the end, you can say the last man of the earth. So it is happening
last mile. Sir, aap ye kehna cha rahe ho ki that people should start looking technology as one of their carriers, because coming back to the context, like we are talking about carrier 2.0. So you feel, one, we all agree that technology will definitely bring a change in the carriers and the way we are looking. Thoda sa is pe, I'll come back to you again, that how you will guide our audience and our listeners ki wo apni career planning, future planning or work planning ko kaise usme technology ka use lein, ya kaise technology se apne aap ko update karein, ya usko use karke better decisions le paen, like informed decisions. So, Madam Ashna, would you like to add something in terms of an informed decision and the informed communication here?
Absolutely, Mr. Seth. I think, highlighting the point that, Professor Basu also brought up in, you also said that, yes, there are, there is a data we have available with us, the United Nations tell us that, 50% of the jobs that we can expect in times to come, people are not even aware of it. So we definitely need to take the right decisions now, upgrade ourselves right now, so that we are prepared to take up those jobs maybe years from now, definitely. Now, how do we do that? We need to be open, keep ourselves open to keep learning. We have to, even our children, at every level, the management level, yes, even at the school level, we have to train them to keep learning and say yes to learning. Learn new technology, learn new things, learn new platforms. Like we were, long back, we were talking about Facebook, then came LinkedIn, then came WhatsApp, then came, so many other Snapchats and Instagram, so many ways of communication, so many different ways of communication, so many different apps have come today that they have made life easy. Now we are talking about artificial intelligence, and it has reached the nooks and corners of the world. So we have to definitely keep ourselves abreast with what are the changes going on and stay tuned with it and adopt them. We cannot say, because it's going to come 2 years from now, I will not do it. No, you have to prepare yourself right now to face what is going to come 2 years hence, or 3 years hence, or a decade hence.
Okay.
Because that's going to be your money. That's how you will still remain employed. If you say no to learning today, तो यू विल नॉट हैव अ जॉब टुमारो बिकॉज़ थिंग्स आर चेंजिंग
वेरी फास्ट करेक्टली सेड मैम.
So taking from this, Professor, ma'am, I come back to you. Like you shared some data and I tried interpreting from different perspectives and different people. How you see those, yes, there are numbers that help us to evaluate. Now as a course correction, how you feel that what should be the direction or what are the cautious lines or cautious calls that the kids or the senior students or the young students or the millennials or even some parents who are the attendees here, it's very, very important because career is a topic that we will not be able to do in one session. And we will request SOCHM to do one or two sessions more over the time to come on this particular topic because it's so vast. But on the numbers, ma'am, what you have shared and what we have heard from our panelists, how you would like to give some top three takeaways for our audience here?
I think it's very important when you think of careers to think of where are the jobs going to be, isn't it? So I have mentioned workforce 2022, what is the mix? But jobs 2022, careers 2.0 in India, what is the mix? Where are the jobs going to be?
Mm.
And such data is again available.
Okay.
So I'm reading from Fiki.
Okay.
And these are majorly going to come under, the first that is listed is healthcare. Mm-hmm. So while preparing, if a lot of jobs are going to be in healthcare, so I should have a career map given my aspirations, my competence. So competence mapping should not happen in an organization. Competence mapping should be happening in schools.
Mm-hmm.
We have a rough competence mapping given the kind of propensity students they have, putting them into streams. So where are the jobs going to be? So this report says jobs are going to be in India 2.0, career 2.0, the future of jobs in India, healthcare, tourism and hospitality, construction, education, logistics and transportation, heavily, heavily technology based.
Mm.
All of them, right? So there is no escaping technology as a fundamental concept, a component, as Mukeshji has already pointed out, of digital migration. I'm not going to use the word transformation, which is going to be an evolution anyways. I'm going to say it's a migration. And we had, owing to the onset of the pandemic, an overnight migration, including our vegetable sellers migrated to Paytm. Cartwalas outside our house, they were not taking cash payments, they were taking Paytm.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So mm-hmm. it's a migration. So these are the places where jobs are going to be. Mm-hmm. I think the second question which I would like to talk about is communication. So mm-hmm. what has communication as integrated communication is fine, but I think harnessing soft power is a far more major thing. What is soft power? Acceptability. How do I get to, how do I make sure the company wants what I want? How do I make sure other countries want what they want?
Mm-hmm.
So today, Germany is ranked top in soft power. So in order to be, we need to be Atmanirbhar. That is, we must have all these indexes checked in a manner so that the world wants us. Because we are good.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to, first be positioned as a global talent hub in all these areas where jobs are going to be, so that people can source talent from us.
Mm-hmm.
And the second thing that we need to do is do adequate signaling that we are ready. So signaling is an essential component of marketing, in fact, branding.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to signal. It's not enough to gain the competence. We need to have signals everywhere, whether it is through schools and activities that they do in educational institutions. We participate in a lot of research and other programs. So enough signaling, enough output signaling, so that the world knows, everyone knows, we are not only Atmanirbhar, but this is a powerful talent hub which is price savvy. which is price savvy. Now, rest of the places. In terms of rural India, I want to contribute one thing because Ganga Prasad ji said something very important. Where do they get the information? I think TRAI has taken huge amount of initiatives in this regard. There are digipreneurs now. There are Suchnapreneurs now. Where not only NGOs, but hybrid organizations with a part NGO and part profit arm have joined this movement to spread digital literacy in the villages and financial inclusion. Particularly in mobile usage, India is the fastest, only next to Indonesia and the world. But if you look at our villages, entertainment value is there through technology, but financial transactions are very low. So this kind of financial inclusion needs to happen. Again, communication plays a very important role. So I think for our students in schools, community projects, making them brand ambassadors of this digital inclusion, teaching people, their counterparts in rural India, would be wonderfully productive if schools were to take up this project partner.
Great. Those are some good inputs where you spoke about adopting migration and those things. So I'll go back to you, Vibhama. When we talk about these things, which is more from a perspective of a millennial or the kids who are started planning at a middle school from a K-12 perspective, how do you see in today's scenario, parents are playing a very, very vital role? Is it equally important for parents to be equally aware from their kids' perspective? And to know what kids should be allowed to be done, like from those mandatory things of just doing medical or like purane time mein hota tha na ki hum ek medical ban gaye, distinction aage to was like a celebration, doctor ban gaye to was like was one in the city. So how do you see how do you see the new generation evolving?
Yes, very rightly said, sir. Actually, I think life is like mathematics. To work out your life, you need formulas that suits your uniqueness. The same is true for a career. A well-planned career is instrumental in happy and satisfied life. Parents having gone through this process can help their children from making mistakes in selecting career. They need to be facilitated and not influence their choices. You must agree that the role of parents in our life holds a lot of values and importance. So although parents have gone through the process, however, the time had changed and their children have a very different environment to deal with. Today, parents are more than just an authority figure. They are like friend, philosopher, and guide. So a more dynamic educational environment where the children are taught to be independent and to take decision on their own. Involved parents होते हैं जो ज्यादा टाइम देते हैं या जो क्वालिटी टाइम की हम बात करते हैं तो आई मस्ट मेंशन दैट कि इन्वॉल्व पेरेंट्स नो देयर चिल्ड्रन द बेस्ट एंड अलोंग विद वाइटल इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट न्यू करियर पाथ्स एंड करियर चॉइसेस दे कैन फैसिलिटेट द प्रोसेस ऑफ करियर सिलेक्शन फॉर देम इजियर सो एज पेरेंट्स वॉन्ट देयर चिल्ड्रन टू ऑप्ट फॉर अ करियर दे नो वेल अबाउट ये ऐसा बहुत होता है कि जिस करियर के बारे में मुझे ज्यादा अच्छे से पता है हम अपने बच्चों को इजीली गाइड कर देते हैं बट इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज राइट बट व्हाट देयर चाइल्ड वांट्स और एस्पायर टू बिकम कैन बी टू कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट थिंग्स डज द रोल ऑफ पेरेंट इन एजुकेशन एंड करियर सिलेक्शन ऑफ देयर चिल्ड्रन इज अटमोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सो आई वॉन्ट टू फिगर आउट इन द वे लाइक देर आर फ्यू फैक्टर्स चार पांच चीजें हैं जिनको जरूर मेंशन करना चाहूंगी The first is aptitude. The child's aptitudes is a mirror of his personality, his strength, and his weaknesses. So, strategically designed aptitude test can reveal a lot of information regarding the student that can help in taking a well-informed career selection. There are so many companies, or you can say career counselors, who are dealing in that. And पहले ये नहीं था संभव आज है बहुत पहले ना तो पेरेंट्स इतने इन्फॉर्म्ड होते थे कि वो बच्चों को बहुत सारी जानकारी दे पाए बट अगर आज भी सारी चीजों के बारे में जानकारी होना संभव नहीं है पेरेंट्स को तो पेरेंट्स भी इन्फॉर्म्ड हो सकते हैं और उसके लिए बहुत सारी संस्थाएं हैं नेशनल वाइड इंटरनेशनल वाइड सो इन्फॉर्मेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग parents need to be informed so that they can guide correctly. The second factor is interest. It is very difficult to spend your life working in a field that you are not interested in. Hence, mm-hmm. the parents should look into the interest of your child and consider it while shortlisting your career option. The third is peer pressure. It is very easy for a child to get influenced by peer pressure into mm-hmm. choosing a career that our majority is opting rather than the one which is best for my child. So sometimes even the parents get attracted to the career choice that is trending, and this ends up hampering the student's performance. So, and the fourth thing is scope. स्कोप जैसे कि अभी मैम ने कहा कि स्कोप कहाँ कहाँ पे है ये हमें जानना जरूरी है और आगे आने वाले 10 सालों में कहाँ स्कोप हो सकता है इसकी जानकारी होनी भी जरूरी है. तो करियर का चुनाव करते समय इन सारी चीजों को ध्यान में रखना बहुत जरूरी है. एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग रेम्यूनरेशन. इवन इफ नॉट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट रेम्यूनरेशन ऑफ करियर होल्ड्स इम्पॉर्टेंस इन वन्स लाइफ. नोबडी लाइक्स टू अर्न पीनट्स. The remuneration should match the child's aspiration and should enable a satisfied and comfortable life. So these are the things.
So Vibha ma'am, I think you gave a very good direction which I was wanting to come because hum bol rahe career 2.0. मैं उसमें ये देखना चाह रहा था कि हमारे audience के लिए ऐसे क्या 4-5 ingredients होने चाहिए which as an audience should focus on. So like I would go backwards. I would say let's put remuneration later stage. I'll come back to you. I'll put a scope later stage. I will love, and I'm just giving a heads up to all our eminent panelists, if we can add the discussion to the direction that how I would say higher level education, say Professor Ma'am from your direction, Mukesh ji from your perspective, when we're talking about the new technologies and jobs coming up, how is it going to add value or change the perspective or orientation of so-called umbrella called career 2.0? Can we work out some white paper as we can assist ASSOCHAM as a body, and that can be submitted back to the department, because this is an ongoing change. So I'll take a lead from what Vibha ma'am said. I'll come to you, Madam Archana, that how do you feel it is going to change from all the first three points which she mentioned, and I leave scope and remuneration for the last discussion because I think that is more debatable, it's situational. But what are the fundamental, like she said, it should be inclusive planning, aap discuss karo, there should not be a peer pressure. Are we in sync of that career 2.0? ye basic cheeze jo bacche bade ho rahe hain, parents evolved calls le rahe hain. So I'd love to hear your words of wisdom and thoughts on that.
To the conversation, it's really a great conversation, and you are absolutely right, sir. Everything boils down to communication, and jaise hum kehte hain, a happy family is a happy child, and that happy parivar ke andar ek communication us level pe ho jahan pe sab ek sabko maloom hai ki kya family plans hai, kya family goals hai. So when we are well aware of what are the family goals, in those goals also comes the goals of each and every child in the family.
Ashram ma'am, can you be a bit more louder? You are not audible. Thoda sa loud hoenge.
Okay, sure sir. Yeah. Sure. So I was saying that yes, you are absolutely right. You're absolutely right, and this is conversation is going to a different dimension altogether, which is very apt. Definitely needs to be discussed. Like everything, you know, boils down to communication. Like you very rightly said, a happy family is, you know, a happy child is nothing but a happy family, and that happens jab ek bahut achhi well rounded communication ho family ke andar, the family ke goals well defined ho, kyunki family goals ke andar har bacche ka goal aata hai, ek perspective aata hai, what is the future which is decided for the child, which happens only in the process of right communication between the family members. So wo bahut zaruri hai, as Vibha ma'am also very rightly said. So yes, that is very very important, and I think iske liye bahut important hai that we are open. We are open, as you are very rightly said sir, ki gone are the days when we used to only think of engineering or MBBS as the options for careers to be pursued. today, like I have an MBA in HR and marketing because at that time, that was the only option available. When my dad asked me, I said, yes, MBA in HR and marketing. Okay, but now today we have MBA in hospital management, in factory management, in so many different areas. So we need to keep our minds open that there is no only one way to go to the temple. There are 100 other ways you can reach the temple. So parents need to, you know, upgrade themselves and understand that there are more than one ways of doing things. Also, people who are already trained, they should not feel, oh, I'm from the marketing background, I cannot go back to this stream, or I cannot take up this new profile. We have to be open. As Professor Basur literally said, signaling is very important. You can throw the right signals only when you upgrade yourself. You are open to accept those changes. So as a family, if we start from those points where it's about family and going forward, yes, the family as a unit has to be very open to accept changes and to accept that, yes, child can go into a profession which is not accepted today, but maybe accepted 20 years, 10 years, 5 years from now. For all these things, for all these decisions to be taken, communication plays an important role. Communication free flow honi chahiye, because today it's not about one way, it's about a discussion. Parivar aaj ki date mein baith ke discussions karte hain, natije pe pahunchte hain jahan pe bacche jo hai parivar ka ek hissa bante hain. Unke upar na hum aaj apna rule thop sakte hain, hum unko apna hissa bana ke chalte hain, integrate karke chalte hain. Then tell, let me tell you sir, children are very very smart today. They give you
smarter than us.
They are the future today and tomorrow. They give you such good advice, and that happens because humne unko allow kiya hai. We have created a platform for them to learn, to use technology, to express their views. जहाँ पे हम डरे नहीं कि मुझे क्या बोलना है, क्या मैं एक्सप्रेस करूँ, कि मुझे डांट तो नहीं पड़ेगी. Where you are given a choice to speak your mind. So families today need to understand that, and I think we are going on that, you know, road. Parents are very progressive today. They have changed and they are accepting change, because if we don't change now, Mr. Seth, then we will never change.
Correct. No, correct. And I think on change, Mr. Mukesh, I would love to hear from you the way you mentioned about the technology AI. But before that, I'll just jump to Dr. Prasad ji. Dr. Prasad ji, you mentioned about a very interesting segment called agricultural community. Now, yes, वहाँ तक पहुँचते हुए बहुत चीजें change हो रही हैं. And Professor ma'am mentioned some good words, digipreneurs, socialpreneurs, village के programs बहुत चल रहे हैं, जिसमें government के CSC initiatives में हम लोग village entrepreneurs, VLEs की बात करते हैं. So आपको क्या लगता है कि are we moving in the right direction? Yes, it will take time, but from a career perspective, मैं audience के लिए आपसे थोड़ा सा viewpoint चाहूँगा that what should be the focused things कि वो अपने आप को थोड़ा सा शहर के करीब लाएं, technology को या अगर adopt करें. जैसे आप देखिए बहुत corporate people are going to farms and saying that oh I'll do an organic farming. Now that is very different from a very conventional agricultural farming which you mentioned, sir. So आप उसको कैसे evaluate करके या रखना चाहेंगे?
देखिए शहर के करीब तो आ नहीं सकते हैं
जी.
क्योंकि सारा लोग विलेजर को शहर के करीब अगर लाया जाए तब तो मुश्किल हो जाएगा.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
बेटर ये होगा कि हम शहर
हम मुकेश जी को लेके मुकेश जी को हर तरफ लेके जाए
लेकर जाए. हाँ, हर जगह जाए. एक एग्जांपल मैं बताता हूँ. एक प्रिंसिपल थे, बोट्सवाना में कुछ दिन रहे थे.
Okay.
मैंने ऐसी बातचीत में पूछा कि बताइए बोट्सवाना में तो आप शहर में रहते होंगे, बहुत फैसिलिटी मिलता होगा. तो बोले नहीं, कि मैं बोट्सवाना में विलेज में रहता था. मतलब कैसे मन लगता था वहाँ? तो बोले कि मन इसलिए लग जाता था कि विलेज में सारा फैसिलिटी शहर का था वहाँ पर.
Okay.
इसलिए मन लग जाता था. तो उस तरह सारा काम करना पड़ेगा, सारा फैसिलिटी उनको देना पड़ेगा, उनके पास टेक्नोलॉजी भी पहुंचाना पड़ेगा, उनके पास कम्युनिकेशन भी पहुंचाना पड़ेगा, उनके पास सारा चीज पहुंचाना पड़ेगा, तब डेवलप डेफिनेटली करेगा. और बहुत बड़ा एक मार्केट है, बहुत बड़ा उसमें एम्प्लॉयमेंट मिलेगा. लोगों को अभी पता नहीं चल रहा है कि कितना बड़ा एम्प्लॉयमेंट का फील्ड है.
सर ये वही वाली सेगमेंट है प्रोफेसर मैम ने 9 सेगमेंट बताए थे आपने एक अनवील कर दिए हैं।
वन मिनट जो एजुकेशन में जो सारे पैनलिस्ट लोग जो बता रहे थे कि टेक्नोलॉजी ऐसे डेवलप होना चाहिए ऐसे मिलना चाहिए ठीक है आप थोड़ा सा एजुकेशन के सिनेरियो देखें पूरा जितने भी बच्चे पढ़ते हैं उसको हम तीन भाग में बांट सकते हैं स्कूल लेवल का हो गया सेकेंडरी लेवल का हो गया हायर एजुकेशन का हो गया हायर एजुकेशन में प्रोफेशनल एंड जनरल एजुकेशन हुआ जितने भी बच्चे पढ़ते हैं उसमें 80% बच्चे जनरल एजुकेशन में पढ़ते हैं और 20% जाते हैं प्रोफेशनल या वोकेशनल या जो भी टेक्निकल कोर्सेज है उनको जाते हैं।
डॉक्टर साहब वी लॉस्ट योर कनेक्शन हेलो
I will fill in while he
Haji, please yeah I was coming to you because
I think he has mentioned something very important I think vocation based education we have been vocational talking courses. about it one somehow must make it local job creation is very important we need smart villages as much as we need smart cities the viability needs to be checked and yes Mukesh ji should give us smart villages. vocation specific trainings like polytechnics we should have hugely available in our districts. Mm-hmm. Everywhere we should have polytechnics available. So general education will lose value gradually as we can see. So when I said healthcare is a job generator, I didn't mean doctors. I meant health analytics.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so there is a huge amount of different jobs we didn't think about, which are emerging. At Ford, we actually offered health analytics course to professionals for free, to doctors, to hospital sector. We just took the registration fee; the rest was free. One reason was we need to do this service because we can. In yeah. education, we have more practice professors. There was a tradition of people leaving industry and then coming. Actually, that is no longer the case. If you have a special capability, we have an MBA in data science right now, mainly because in data science, we are lacking in the world. We need to develop competence. I don't see any reason why these cannot be moved deep into the country.
Mm-hmm.
Why education cannot be moved in all these fields deep into the country. So I did not mean conventional roles at all. So we have teaching professionals, but we also have practice professors who work very closely with the industry to aid in design and thinking in the industry. And they come back to the classroom and train the workforce. So I hope we can get Ganga Prasad ji back because I was so enjoying listening to him. I wonder what has happened to his.
No, I'm sure he will come back. Till the time we move to Mukesh ji. Mukesh ji, everyone is looking up to you. Like you have to get technology everywhere. आप ये नहीं कह सकते सर कि मैं AI खाली e-commerce को दूंगा. Yes, we have to evolve, and that's a very good request where ma'am mentioned about that the way the perspectives are changing, the new jobs are coming, and I think it's a very burning point for all of us. Like what all you as eminent panelists have spoken things about journey mapping, communication, signaling. इसके लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि हम इसको रूरल सेगमेंट में या लार्जर कम्युनिटी में लेके जाएं। आई थिंक अब वो टाइम आएगा जहां पे हम इसको अर्बन और रूरल का डिफरेंशिएट नहीं करेंगे द थिंग्स हैव टू चेंज तो उसमें आपको क्या लगता है विल टेक्नोलॉजी जैसे कहते हैं ना टेक्नोलॉजी इज क्रिएटिंग बैरियर्स और इज ब्रिजिंग बैरियर्स व्हाट डू यू फील हियर सर
आई थिंक टेक्नोलॉजी इज द बिगेस्ट डेमोक्रेटाइज दिस डे And because it's not now have and have not. If you have really attitude, you wanted to learn, I think YouTube universities are there. Many people are doing many new things by learning through this YouTube itself, right? Mm-hmm. So it is free. So that's the things are there. So in fact, many new things are happening. And if you go by, because it's just ongoing generation and ongoing technology changes are happening in future, and it's not very distant. Your all counseling career would be happening through the machine, because they able to read your mind, they would able to read your behavior, And based on that, you can say you have a creative mind. You can go in this industry. You are more towards like a physical work. You go towards, so they can give the broad, and it is already available with many of the universities. It is happening there. Only question, yes, sir, it is migrated from the big cities to the metro cities, to the small cities, and to the villages. It is not, but internet is the biggest platform. So the things is going, it's reaching slowly and slowly. And the new, in fact, smartphone would be available. I think Jio has just announced recently.
Correct.
It is affordable smartphone. So I'm sure it's not a day away that technology will not reach to the village level. And these are gone that you required very formal education. Just formal education up to 10, 12. Then you go for the vocation, and then you have a lot of e-learning classes and other things, and you keep on upskilling. Upskilling is the continuous learning process. Because you said, okay, I'm from the Harvard, I have did my MBA. Today you are useful, but down the line after 5 years, there is no value between the Harvard school and somebody's who's not educated formally, but he's an entrepreneur. He need to work under his or her, right? So it is about the mindset, and of course you need the technology to enable and achieve to whatever you are dreaming, you need to pursue. So it is important about mindset. Technology should not be, you should not be slave of the technology. You should be continue use technology as per your understanding, as per your resource, and how do you get it. But yes, these days I would say technology is the biggest democratic things. Anybody and everybody, to most of the extent, not everything, but to most of the extent, it is affordable. You can get it there.
No, and, Dr. Mukesh, I think, sorry, yeah, please.
Just to add some practical things during the discussion, because I am going through all these phases. My daughter is now entering to the college. She has just completed her 12th from international school. So naturally, I am receiving it. She is deciding what to do.
So it's the right time we are doing Career 2.0 then.
Yes. So a lot of research now kids are doing. They know that after the education, what they need to do. And after the like first level of education, we need to break the things there and go for the relearning and again restart the career. So career is not just about for the new generation kids just to earning money. I think how it is going to give the value addition, how they are contributing, going to contribute in the sort of societies, and ultimately the satisfaction to individual.
Correct. So I'll summarize very good things which you shared and you have left for our audiences, that technology is the most, the new democratized commodity right now. We should not be the slave. And few things like reskilling, upskilling, and how we optimally utilize this technology. So taking this technology, that how it can be upskill, resize, rescale. Dr. Prasad, very own Dr. Prasadji is back. So Dr. Prasadji, we come back to you to hear what you were throwing light on, sir. Sir, aapka awaaz nahi aa raha. You have to unmute yourself, sir.
No,
we can hear you now. We can hear you, sir.
Now it is good.
Yes, sir.
So technology is definitely very useful and helpful in education. So before pandemic, what you have done? There were no e-learning, no virtual classes, no online classes in the university or in general education. In IIT level, in IIM level, there is something happening, such type of thing. But during pandemic, what happened? All students, all guardians, all teachers are using this technology because something has compelled them. As student compelled to remain at homes, educational institutions are almost closed since April 2020. E-learning through webcam and a smartphone pick up and going to move forward. Demand of online courses created so much. So we are using technology. So when technology is fulfilled in the general education, then definitely unemployment will be reduced, and the several technology adopted job will be available for the youth. So we'll definitely use the technology in general
education. Correct, sir. Correct.
Isme ek cheez I would love to hear from you, Madam Archana, like technology hai. जी आ रही है सर, आ रही है आपकी आवाज सर, कैन यू हियर अस? ओके, सो मैम अर्चना, व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड इफ यू कैन थ्रो सम लाइट, बिकॉज सी लार्जली आई फील विद सो मच ऑफ
साउंड
सर, आपका आवाज आ रहा है हमें, वी कैन हियर यू अर्चना मैम, कैन यू हियर मी?
यस आई कैन हियर यू सर.
यस यस सर. यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल.
ओके ओके okay, I'm audible. So Archana ma'am, what we were trying to understand from you, like when we go to this segment, a lot of younger generation is very perplexed, they're very confused also at a point of time. So how you feel that the communication can be simplified, or it can be in a more simpler manner, because at times kai baar discuss karte karte things gets very complex. So how do you feel the, yes, we have understood communication plays a very very important role, it's quite vital, it's quite integrated. But can you just help us to elaborate the word communication for the benefit of our audience as a perspective from a career perspective? Ek ho gaya normal communication ki messaging jani chahiye, and I would like you to, ma'am, throw light on the words like signaling, the new job opportunities. Over to you, ma'am.
Yeah, absolutely. So you know, yes, you are right, communication, but I always lay emphasis on effective communication. कि जो आपकी कम्युनिकेशन जिसके लिए टारगेटेड है, क्या उसको वो चीज समझ आ रही है. सो वी नीड टू सिंप्लीफाई आवर कम्युनिकेशन टू सूट व्हाट हु इट इज टारगेटेड टू. फॉर दैट इट इज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट टू नो द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द पर्सन वी आर टॉकिंग टू. जब नहीं पता चलेगा कि हमारे ऑडियंस सामने कौन है, वो क्या समझना चाहते हैं, उनकी रिक्वायरमेंट्स क्या हैं, we will not be able to pinpoint what we want them to understand. So it is important to understand their interest, talk in talk to them with data, and whenever we are communicating, it is important ki hum we tell them the reason why we are communicating with them, so that they know at the end of the communication what is it that they will gain out of it. We have to hold their interest to tell them whatever they are interested in, whatever career they want to pursue, I will be able to answer all those questions for them. When in my communication they get all the answers, that is when the communication will reach them. So that is the most important thing, to be able to reach your audience, to be able to reach those children, read their minds, understand their minds, and give them a platform where they are not hesitant in interacting with you. They should be given a free platform to talk to you, to express their views, to be interactive, to be able to have a dialogue instead of just one way communication. Jab hum wo karte hain, then hamari communication bahut simplify ho jati hai, because hum samajh pa rahe hain what is it that they want, and we give them the same thing. And when you are able to build that trust that yes, my answers will help you, my answers will give you a direction, my answers will help you reach your goals, be it career, be it professional, be it personal, then they will stay with you till the end of the communication. They will stay with you till the end of the session. So that is very, very important. Even in rural segment, if we go, hum wahan par wo communication nahi use kar sakte jo hum apne urban sector mein use karte hain. क्योंकि हमें उस लेवल पे जाके उनसे बात करनी है, ताकि हम उनका लेवल समझ सके, वो समझ सके कि उनकी रिक्वायरमेंट क्या है. वंस वी अंडरस्टैंड देयर रिक्वायरमेंट सर, इट विल गेट सिंपलीफाइड, इट विल
परफेक्ट. परफेक्ट परफेक्ट मैम, एंड टू दिस आई विल कम लेटर टू यू, जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ कैन कम्युनिकेशन बी आल्सो बी वन ऑफ द कैरियर, लाइक उसको जैसे अगर हम पब्लिक स्पीकिंग बोले या कुछ और तरीके से बोले. आई विल कम बैक टू दिस, बट बिफोर लाइक आई हैव वन क्वेश्चन फॉर वन ऑफ अवर पैनलिस्ट, बिकॉज़ ही हैज सम अदर कमिटमेंट्स. So Mukesh ji, when we spoke about technology, we would love to learn one quick insight. Algorithm or machines ke liye AI is good, is very important, gives you the data and analytics. Jaise ma'am ne bataya, professor ma'am ne, that logistics, एनालिटिक्स इज अ गुड डोमेन. कई बार होता है कि मशीन, यहाँ पे अब टेक्नोलॉजी मेरे माइंड को रीड कर रही है एंड इट इज थ्रोइंग बैक ऑन मी वॉट दे हैव लर्न फ्रॉम मी. देर माइट बी अ सिचुएशन इफ आई एम इन अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ दैट सजेशन और इफ आई एम इन अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ दैट सिचुएशन, हाउ डू यू सी दैट शुड आई गो विद माई माइंड और शुड आई गो विद द टेक्नोलॉजी, वॉट टेक्नोलॉजी इज फीडिंग मी बैक.
In AI, one of these, I would say it's a new adoption. It is called sentiment analysis.
Correct. Yeah.
So, in fact, there are a few institutes. If you go through that, you will have the your personality test, right? They will ask multiple questions, and AI inbuilt system in the machine, they will try to understand what kind of your personality is there. So based on that, they will give you indication that you are towards this particular segment. Mm-hmm. Just come back to like day-to-day kind of things. So when you are doing like suppose e-commerce society, or you are in a hospital and there is an AI chatbot is there. So you keep on asking the question, you are getting the answer, right? After certain stage, sometime you get irritated with the answer, because if something wrong is written and algorithm is wrong, you'll get the wrong answer one day.
Correct, correct. But
AI cannot correct the wrong thing, right? It is a human being who are coding this thing, they need to do that. But they will, the way you are talking with the machine and the way you are typing, she will say, he or she, depend upon the product. She will say, it look like you're not happy with my answer. Should I connect with my human colleague? And then it will connect to your human agent. So these are the technology already happening. Coming about, should I go by this when you have a split of mind? Because the biggest thing is human being is not machine. And it's a keep on changing. Your mind is keep on changing. So one particular situation, one particular time, you are in different mood, and different situation and different time, you are different mood. So ultimately, this decision has to be taken by the human being. Only if you go by this data, you might not be taking the right decision.
Sure.
So it has to be like a different situation. What are you have gone through that? Then proper analysis of the data, and then you can only suggestion, because AI can give you the machine suggestion. If you start implementing everything in AI, then you are basically leading towards the disaster.
Okay.
And what is called in AI is basically ethical AI or non-ethical AI, because it is basically mimic your human being intelligence. So it is important that whosoever developer is there, they should know what is the objective of this thing. So that is very, very important.
No, thanks, Mr. Mukesh. A lot of good insights you have given. I really appreciate that. And I'm sure audience would have also benefited. Now, taking a lead from there, I'll come to you, Vibha ma'am. When we are talking about adoption on technology, I'll hold some technology for a minute. Yes, Mukesh, you can carry on.
Take the permission to all of you. I have another engagement.
Please, thank you very much.
Sorry for quitting in between.
No worries. So, Vibha ma'am, you're looking for a segment where we have kids from kindergarten and moving on to the next level. Do you feel that this technology or this whole time, last 18, 24 months, the way the education is being imparted, is this helping to identify a new career opportunities for people, for the community? Because see, career ek bahut badi cheez hai jo har phase pe apna perspective badal rahi hai. So yes, from day one, definitely the kids are not going to think about career, but as a community, which is teaching the kids, the community, the infrastructure, teachers, which is working for it, teachers, how do you see the change for them from a career and this career 2.0 perspective?
Yes, sir.
Looks like we
very valid question and very important question. Am I audible enough?
Yes, ma'am, you are. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So this is really very, very important question, because when we talk about small kids age group from 3 years to 12 years, okay? So two perspectives are there. Ek bachcho ke perspective se bhi hum dekh sakte hain, aur ek aapne kaha career perspective, jo teachers ke perspective se ya school authority ke perspective se, aur teesra hai sir parents प्रोस्पेक्टिव, वो क्या सोचते हैं इस नए वे ऑफ टीचिंग के बारे में. तो इनके तीन प्रोस्पेक्टिव हैं. अगर बच्चों के बारे में हम बात करें तो ऑफकोर्स उनके लिए टफ है एंड बहुत अच्छा नहीं है, बट चूंकि हमारे पास कोई और ऑप्शन नहीं है. अगर हम बात करें कि कोई बच्चा जी नर्सरी और वन क्लास नहीं है, उसे डायरेक्टली आप टू में नहीं डाल सकते. अगर हम उसे ऑनलाइन क्लास नहीं दे रहे हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं हम उसके ऊपर एक ऐसा प्रेशर दे रहे हैं जो उसे 2-3 साल बाद एक बार में बहुत ज्यादा प्रेशर हो जाएगा. तो बेटर टू अवॉइड दैट वी हैव टू इनिशिएट इट एट द वेरी अर्ली एज, इवन इफ इट इज ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन. बट द वे ऑफ एजुकेशन शुड बी इंटरैक्टिव, इंटरेस्टिंग एंड एज पर द नॉर्म्स ऑफ एजुकेशन. लाइक बहुत ज्यादा ड्यूरेशन नहीं होना चाहिए छोटे बच्चों के लिए एंड बहुत सारी चीजें. अगर हम करियर की बात आज कर रहे हैं, हम करियर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से बात करें, डिजिटली स्किल्ड, दे आर हैविंग लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. हमारे स्कूल में बहुत सारी टीचर्स थी जो बहुत अच्छी टीचर्स थी, लेकिन दे वेयर नॉट टेक्नोलॉजी साउंड. So what we did, I just said one thing, do you operate smartphone? They said yes. I said, okay, now we are going to teach you how to operate Zoom or any other platform. Okay, and you will surprise, sir, they learn, they are taking classes like everything. So it is just at this place, if teachers can learn, so there is opportunity.
Correct.
Those
correct.
Who are not ready to learn, those who are not ready to accept, for them there is no opportunity. But हमने सिर्फ एक महीने का समय लिया था, और हमारे जैसे बहुत organizations हैं जिन्होंने of course बहुत सारे teachers को सिखाया होगा. तो IT division का बहुत important role है, and teachers, not only teachers, admin है, बहुत सारे staff होते हैं. We need to train them. And technology, of course, it is not like we can't teach, we can't learn. We can learn at any stage. At our last breath, till our last breath, we should learn. No? This is the thing which our parents used to tell us. So we have to. Yes.
So you leverage technology for enhancing the opportunities and careers for those people, whether there was the admin staff, the support staff, or the teachers.
See, if I will say after COVID, job vacancies were not too much. Why? Because we actually need technology sound people. और सब लोग बहुत जल्दी adopt नहीं कर पाते हैं. तो जितना vacancy और job पहले था, जब technology का उतना सारा हमें नहीं लेना पड़ता था, उतना job और उतना vacancy आज नहीं है. Technology को आप कितना भी sound कर ले, number of jobs अगर आप ठीक है, तो कभी नहीं हो सकता ऐसे. टेक्नोलॉजी कभी भी प्लेस नहीं ले सकता है नंबर ऑफ पर्सन का, बट वी डोंट हैव ऑप्शन एंड वी हैव टू गो दिस वे ओनली. सो यस, फॉर दोज पीपल हु आर वेरी हु आर लुकिंग फॉर अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड हु आर कीन टू लर्न, इट इज द राइट टाइम टू लर्न, इट इज द राइट टाइम टू अंडरस्टैंड लर्निंग. जहां भी आप टेक्नोलॉजी में, जहां भी आप है, वहां से आगे का सीखना जरूरी है.
Perfect. No, very aptly put across, Vibha ma'am. And coming back to you, Professor ma'am, like we used words like signaling, migration, effective communication. And in the beginning, you shared some very exciting numbers and avenues. So I'd like to take some guidance and thoughts from you for the audience from a career perspective. Again, I think I'm trying to bring the topic back to the career because ye bahut open hai. खाली एजुकेशन से रिलेटेड नहीं है, खाली टेक्नोलॉजी से रिलेटेड नहीं है, बिकॉज इन दिस होल सिनेरियोस इट इज ऑल कंटिन्यूअसली चेंजिंग. चेंज हैज बिकम अ रेगुलर थिंग नाउ, इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट थिंग. सो व्हाट यू फील दैट पीपल एट दोज लेवल, द किड्स एट दैट लेवल, वेदर द कम्युनिटी एट दैट लेवल, हाउ दे शुड अडैप्ट, हाउ दे शुड वर्क एंड सी कैरियर, द वर्ड कैरियर इन अ न्यू डायमेंशन, उसके ऊपर इफ यू कैन मैम कैन थ्रो सम लाइट.
आई वर्क विद यंग प्रोफेशनल्स एंड अ लॉट ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट्स हैव वर्क एक्सपीरियंस एंड इट इज वेरी वेरी क्रिटिकल इन बिकॉज आई टीच एमबीए.
ओके.
एवरी क्लास अल्टीमेटली गेट्स कनेक्टेड टू अ करियर. So knowledge building is the way to getting the career. So we take
Yes.
knowledge as a lifelong skill capacity and which you need to build on to get a career and to deepen that career, to strengthen that career. So not a single class of mine and similarly others where career is not mentioned. This goes, in fact, beyond what I say communication, although my area is communication. I'm an anthropologist. So this goes beyond. Today, what we call is interaction maturity.
Okay.
It is not information maturity we are worried about. Information is available.
Mm-hmm.
Internet is available. You can go to Google. You can get the information. But what do you do with that information? Now, what do you do? Is it enough to make you understand and leverage? The information is not enough to make you leverage. What
mm-hmm.
you need is interaction, a deepening of interaction. And I'll give an example in this regard, and I'm very glad we constantly talk career. So if an internship project is happening under me, if a life project is happening, and the interaction goes to, okay, how are you going to leverage this exactly when you join the workforce? How will this help you? What are the key contributions that you're making? How did the entity or the organization benefit? At the same level, we need at the school level. At the school, we have to remember, in India, all are early adopters of technology. Our kids are early adopters. If you look at us, we are late adopters.
Mm-hmm.
We had to really run to catch up with our kids. The kids are early adopters even in rural India. They understand technology better simply because they grew up with technology. We did not. But when I asked my son, and I'm going anecdotal, and one should not go anecdotal because it's not real data, but it's a good story. So
yeah.
He's also completing his 12th, which got canceled. And I asked him, what do you want to do? And I left the decision to him, and I would have been okay with anything. So he said, I am interested in energy science and quantum computing. So I said, did you come across these words? I mean, who told you? Is it from school? It's a great school. I will
mm-hmm.
not tell the name of the school.
Sure,
so we did not have the conversation in school. This is how did you chance upon it?
Mm-hmm.
So he has, because of they have always studied computer science. They've always studied IT. He and maybe some kids like him, but have been able to take it a little forward to interact and see where the jobs are. Once again, he has gone back to seeing where the jobs are. Although he loves astrophysics, he's saying jobs are not there.
Mm-hmm.
In quantum, jobs are there.
Got it, got it.
But is every kid thinking like this? And I don't want to praise my son. Somehow,
sure.
He got there. But what I realized was, shouldn't there have been an interaction? I'm not just
mm-hmm.
saying communication. Communication mm-hmm. is there. Information level is there. Interaction maturity we have to achieve if we want career 2.0. It's not
mm-hmm.
enough to know where the jobs are, what kind of jobs, how do they match with my skills, how do I build my skills therefore to match with the job. You see, organizations are no longer looking at who I want to hire. They
mm-hmm.
are increasingly looking at, these are the jobs I have, so who fits that job? It's a very different thing from
yes.
who I am hiring. So I am basically looking at jobs. I'm not looking at people. Whether we may like it, we may dislike it.
Correct,
but
correct.
This is real.
This
in
is
fact,
real.
We are talking about resume-less interviews.
Yeah.
They are allowing AIs to match whatever skill sets there are, and only then they will talk to people. This is a reality. And we are training our students to face that reality every single day. Because in schools, nobody expects jobs, but from
mm-hmm.
us, the basic expectation is we will get them career ready.
Mm-hmm.
So interaction, we need to talk about interaction maturity.
Interaction word, yes.
So
that was a nice word for
democracy. We need to go to interaction democracy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
No, that's very, very strong, because it helps, and it will really help people to understand
yeah.
that how they can leverage their strength, their caliber, to
to the particular segment or the particular sector, what is that they are looking at. Though coming to you, Dr. Prasad, I understand that agriculture as a segment or villages, these things coming there will take its own sweet time. Yes, but what was happening before? So like if it earlier it was taking 7 years, 10 years, now it is happening in 3 years, 2 years. So time is still getting shortened up. How do you feel that agriculture will bounce back and will be looked upon agriculture as a new perspective? Because as a word, a lot of people talk about agri-tech, but is it in a real sense? That is what we would love to hear from you.
No, definitely agriculture will bounce back.
Okay.
And new technique will be available in next 3 to 5 years. So there will be so many changes you can see in the agriculture side. So government and several other society, NGO are working there. So definitely it will be bounced back.
Definitely. No, I think that as it's an indication that with the coming of technology, jaise aapne pehle bhi bola, with all those things coming there, it will create more avenues for people. It will create more opportunities. Jaise hum log bolte hain ki jobs banao, jobs create karo un opportunities ke liye, un logon ke liye. And as even Professor Ma'am mentioned in the beginning, that a lot of new things are coming up, like health analytics. So jobs banti hain.
Job to wahan banenge na, jab technology aayenge, sara वहाँ फैसिलिटी जाएगा, तब जो चिप्स जो बनते हैं बड़े बड़े ब्रांड कंपनी में वो सब वहाँ बनने लगेंगे। तो वहाँ जब बनेंगे तो वहाँ के लोगों को नौकरी मिलेगा, वहाँ के लोग ट्रेंड होंगे, वहाँ के लोग देखेंगे, सारा चीज तो उधर बनने लगा। टोमेटो सॉस बनता है, किसान का जब आता है तो 100 रुपीज बिकेगा और वही टोमेटो 5 रुपीज पर केजी ले जाता है लोग, तो वो वहीं पर बनाएंगे, वो जानेंगे। फूड टेक्नोलॉजी पार्क बनेगा, सब जगह फूड प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट बनेगा, तो दे विल बी ट्रेंड, सो इट विल कम वेरी सून।
नो पर्सपेक्टिव, वेरी नाइस पर्सपेक्टिव, आई थिंक वी टेक इट फॉरवर्ड। सो आई विल हेड टुवर्ड्स द समिंग अप ऑफ द सेशन एंड आई विल हैव ऑल द अदर रेस्ट 3 एमिनेंट पैनलिस्ट जस्ट टू say in a very short one-liner message that the message for our audience, that how we should look at knowledge which is invading our life, technology which is in and out everywhere, how these two things should complement the word called career, which is pretty ambiguous right now, but how we can start evaluating it in a better manner. So over to you, Vibha ma'am, first.
I think we all have to keep on learning, and नई चीजें आती रहेंगी, changes are very imminent, and उस change को हमें adopt भी करना है, सीखना भी है, और उसके साथ वक्त के साथ चलना है। This is the only thing which I could learn in last 1.5 year, and I just want to say my audience that be professional. Professionalism is very, very important word and very vast word, but we have to be professional if you are looking for career or job.
Thank you. Over to you, Ashna ma'am. Ma'am, you have to unmute yourself.
Sound is not good.
So yeah, thank you so much. So as we sum up this very beautiful conversation, you know, I would just like to add in towards the end, you know, it's very important to be like water. Hum sabko ye seekhna hai from this whatever stage we are in currently, be like water. Water takes the shape of the vessel it is in. Be like water, taste like water. You should be able to absorb, keep your antennas on, absorb knowledge. We are never too big, too knowledgeable to learn. So be like water, absorb kariye, be ready, keep your antennas on, make your framework of your life just very, very malleable, you know, and just look ahead, keep making small term goals so that you keep achieving your final goal that you have in your mind. keep changing yourself, because change is the only thing constant. And you will enjoy the journey. Everyone will enjoy the journey when you accept this, and accept this very gracefully, that you will never harm yourself or your people or your ecosystem if you are a malleable person, if you are a person who's adaptable, if you're a person who's ready to learn, ready to accept things and move on. Never, you know, get your shoulders heavy with knowledge. It is your driver to take you to the path of success and achieve your goals. Thank you.
No, very beautifully summed up. We really appreciate the perspective. Over to you, ma'am.
For professionals, we have to understand we live in a, I'm going to go backwards.
Huh? Okay.
For professionals, you, me, and my professional students, we live in a world where we are talking distributed innovation, distributed efficiencies. Otherwise, we don't have equilibrium. So we have to understand. If we lack equilibrium, that means hamara competitiveness kam ho jayega. And for me and you and my students, I'm going to say something very harsh, which I believe in. People may not like it. Either think about a career or don't think. There is nothing in between.
Very well said. I think
beech mein kuch nahi hota hai for us. Now, if we take it back to roll it back a little, the story back a little, I think from graduation, one should understand absolutely what am I getting out of it? Whether you're studying in private or the government pays for it, it's subsidized. How is this going to make me stronger? If you roll it back to school, I think the interaction maturity at a senior level should start in 10th onwards. I am absolutely I'm absolutely in favor of understanding children, but absolutely opposed to not letting them enjoy their childhood. So I think we need to watch, observe, understand kids, but we need to let them be free. Until a point when they achieve maturity of their body and mind, so that they start participating in a bigger way in decision making. So interaction maturity should start from school. At my level, I understand either I have it or I don't have it. There is no in between, and that's harsh, but that's what I believe in.
No, perfect. I think very rightly sum up in terms of words like learning, in terms of words like changing, in terms of words like be water, and in terms of like you summing up that there is nothing in between. So I really appreciate the different perspectives which came from you, and Dr. Prasad, you also really highlighted the future, the way things are changing, the way things will change in the agricultural community and the whole segment, which is a huge and a very large population and the segment of our industry. Now, moving back to our host and our panels and our body, which is the SOCHM. So I'll come back to you, Bharat. I think you left us for a good, insightful session. We have a lot of good engagements. We have a lot of good verbatims, a lot of good perspectives coming out in the discussion.
Thanks to you.
No, ma'am, it's all of us. All of us has great learnings, great insights. And a lot to share. I'm sure the time may be short. We can keep it more interactive. So I really appreciate all of your great knowledge, great insights, practical perspective. I think the most important thing which we are trying to pass on to our audience is we have to be practical. We have to learn. We have to be agile. We have to be very clear. We should know what we are talking and to whom we are talking and how it can be benefiting. So a lot of good takeaways for all of us. So I would sum up our discussion here, Bharat, and I'll hand over your platform back to you now. Bharat, over to you.
Thank you, Manuji, for this wonderful moderation, I would say. And I would like to thank each one of you, the panelists, Professor Basu, Ms. Archana Garg, Vibha Singh ma'am, Mukesh ji, who has left with us, Dr. Gagan Prasad Singh, for taking time from their busy schedule and joining with us. The future depends. I would just like to close this whole session with Mahatma Gandhi. The future depends upon what you do today. The future depends on what you do today, as told my Mahatma Gandhi. We will get through this, and we'll find a way to continue on in a safe and responsible manner, going back to work and taking the time and precaution to ensure we do the best job we can. In just one way, we can ensure we have a bright future. So these days, we all are talking about unlearning and relearning. Because you know, change is something we need the most, and change is something we resist the most. So thank you very much from the core of my heart, with deep sense of gratitude, to all of you. Thank you very much for this wonderful session.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks,
thank you,
ma'am.
Everyone.
Thanks, Dr.
Thanks very much. It's a privilege.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.